she's steering PayPal India and ensuring that all payments that are happening from India to overseas and vice versa are happening in the most seamless manner. PayPal has been an industry leader, and I'm going to ask Tanya what are the ways in which PayPal is making sure that the dominance is maintained, and how are Indian businesses actually being plugged abroad? How are they, you know, these consumers who were once only used to simple ways are now getting onto the digital platform, yes, and actually leveraging the global exposure as well as the opportunities that, yeah, cross-trade is offering.
Yeah. So thank you for that question, Ashika. We've been in this country for more than 8 years now. We launched in 2011 with the aim of actually taking small and medium-term exporters global. And that's what we do well globally. We start out in a market, and our aim in that market is always to give global access, a global platform, you know, a chance to transact in global currencies and yet be cost efficient to the merchant. We have more than 1 million merchants today who accept PayPal as a platform to receive money. And we pride on the fact that we've been able to, you know, not just grow as a business in India, but grow these exporters' businesses in India.
Right.
Today, we're able to get them access to, you know, so many million consumers who are PayPal users and who trust PayPal, and therefore are able to bring that trust onto the exporter who's new to that market. Hence, he looks at us because we as a company stand for safety, convenience and trust. And the exporter knows that he'll be able to gain access through this brand, and that's what we pride ourselves in.
Tell me, you've been from the banking background and now you're in the, yes, digital payment spaces. Tell me, what is the one thing that you think makes you absolutely suitable to steer a digital service like PayPal?
Thank you again for that question. I think, we are in an economy today which is slated to be, $1 trillion of digital payments by 2023. That's not going to be possible without the partnership of banks, payment companies, technology companies, regulators, policymakers to think in a certain manner. Because we're trying to enable, you know, so many million merchants who today are used to cash and are used a certain way, and consumers who are slowly adapting to payments through a mobile, but still would go back to cash if there was no cashback. So as a person with a banking and a payments, now in payments, I would say that we have to leverage what's best out of banking, put it in a technology which is simple and convenient for the consumer, and add on the safety aspect to the merchant, and make it available in as quick and as fast a way as possible. So that's what I see. I see an amalgamation of so many people coming together, because everybody wants to go digital. It's part of the Digital India vision which the government has. And besides digital payments, we have cybersecurity and digital financial literacy, which is a part of that program. So I think we're all tending towards a common goal. And so long as we stick towards that, we have this great goal of $1 trillion waiting to be achieved.